So this is the page where we can do that. Simply you go to the URL which I have given in the description and sign in with your Google account. After that, just click on this play button. Once you click on it, it will connect to the GPU in the backend. So it is successfully connected. Now it runs this script. It will just install all the dependencies that are required to run this application. So give it some time. Once you see this local URL and public URL, it means that our application is ready to use. Now what you have to do is just click on this gradio.live link. It will open in a new tab. And this is our application. It's completely ready. You can just give a prompt to it and it will generate the image you want. Let's try some simple image. Click on generate. So now the image is being generated. You can also see the preview in a moment. As the actual image is being generated, you can see it live. Our first image is ready. By default, Focus will generate two samples of our text input. Let's see the first image. This is pretty neat. It's actually looking like a picture that we have taken. I think in the second image, it lost the touch and it has given two dogs. It completely ignored our first word, cat. So it happens. So AI can make mistakes. That's fine. But the image is pretty neat. So this is how you can generate a simple image by simply entering your prompt here and then clicking on generate. Let's explore the other options. Input image and enhance is going to be complex, so nice. I'm not going to explain it to you now. We can have it for another session, but I'll show you the advanced. So here in advanced, we have these settings. Preset, which is initial by default. We can click and choose any of these from the list. Let it be the initial. And the performance, you can choose any of these. Now the other option is aspect ratio, which is nothing but the width and height of the image that you want to generate. So by default, this is the one. Based on your prompt, you can change the aspect ratio. That is your choice. So the other option is image number. So this decides how many images the focus has to generate. By default is 2, but you can change it by this slider up to 32 images. Let's keep it 2 for now. Coming to output image, we have 3 options: PNG, JPEG and WebP. I recommend to use PNG because it is a high quality image. Negative prompt. Basically, you should be using negative prompt if you want picture perfect images. You can Google it, like saying what can be the negative prompts that I can give to focus, and then you can add it here. Other option is this seed. If you untick this random, it will show you this input box, which is nothing but in your image generation, something like if you want to create an influencer model and the face has to be same for each generation, give a particular number here and throughout the generation, you should maintain that number. So in each generation, it will have the similarity. So those are the main options that we need to know to generate the image. Let's give some other prompts. So after typing the prompt, you just click on generate. Our first image is ready. Let's see, all perfect. So we can see some issue with the eyes, but we can simply make some changes in our prompt and fix it. So this time let's try with the native prompt. So the issue that we are getting is with the eyes. Let's try and give something related to eyes. So let's try the image again. The first image is ready. Let's open and see. You see, it's a picture perfect. The person in the front and everything in the background is blur. So the crowd is also real and there is a monument in the background. And he is facing the camera, just like how we asked it. So the quality is nice, the facial features, especially the eyes this time. It did not mess it up. So it is pretty neat. Let's go and check the second image. This is also a similar image. We have this sun rays falling on his face on one side. So this we did not ask it for, so it took the liberty of adding more creative things to the image. So this is actually a good thing until and unless it creates a mess on the person's face or on your whole picture. So once it is generated, you can simply click on this icon, download icon, to download your image, and it will be downloaded to your machine. So that's how you generate images using Focus. Let's try and create one more image. The image is really good. It looks as if we have taken a picture of the real cat and dog. This is so impressive. Coming to the styles, you can just choose any style. You can just hover on these styles and then see how the image looks. Let me select this focus masterpiece. The second image is more creative than the first one. So these two settings will be helpful to you in creating your images. So go ahead and try the application. I'll provide the link in the description. Just click on it and explore the focus application. One bonus tip for you all guys. If you don't know what to give as an input to the text box in focus application, you can just ask ChatGPT. You can ask like this: create a prompt to feed into focus AI to generate beautiful girls from different countries. Also include native prompt. This is just for an example I have taken. You can just ask anything, submit. Now ChatGPT will give you some prompt. So it has generated several different prompts, including country names and background and different clothing styles for the person. And it also included a negative prompt here. So let's try with this one first. Copy and then paste it here. And if you want to add negative prompt, you click on advanced and copy the negative prompt from here and then paste it here. Now click on generate. The first image is ready. Let's open and see. So it is good, but you can tweak it more to your taste. You can change the background by replacing and adding some more features. So it's quite good. Let's try another prompt. This time the country is France. Paste, generate. I let the native prompt as it is. Let's see. So it is quite good. It created a realistic image, even if it is taken from ChatGPT. So ChatGPT or any other GPTs can help you really well with these text prompts. Go ahead and ask what you want. So the second image is more realistic than the first one. It's impressive. If you like the video, like, share and subscribe to the channel. Also comment what will be the next video that you want to see on my channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.